scoring contest.
We're getting set for action here in Ottawa, capital of all of Canada.
Stamford, Connecticut,
your lordship,
230 pounds, Tony.
Wonderful country, Canada.
Dynamite.
Certainly is. Always love to visit.
His opponent, from
the weather has just been beautiful
Mountain,
as of late.
Weighing 249 pounds.
So many different elements.
Jake the Snake.
Here in the natural surroundings of Canada. What a lovely, lovely country this is.
Well, consider the elements of this singles matchup we're about to see. These days, anytime you sign a contract to take on one Jake the Snake Roberts, it could be your last. He's now bringing a King Cobra to the ring.
Oh,
and a nice view, the hood up and everything.
Oh, gosh, that's an angry cobra there.
Your lordship, I am told that the venom from a cobra can drop a bull elephant. You can imagine what it can do to a man.
Well, in that case, remind me not to get any closer to the ring than we are right now.
See, Jake shows great caution wearing a very thick leather glove on that right hand, but he still reaches over and slaps the head.
Ooh, I wouldn't do that.
That cobra, and that is tempting fate if I've ever seen it.
I would say so.
And Tony Diamond wants absolutely no parts of the snake, either one, at the moment.
No.
Neither does a referee.
No. And there's thousands and thousands upon people present here today who wouldn't want a part of it either. That's about up now. The snake is in the
I'm not sure what Diamond is trying to argue about, but he had better keep his distance. That snake is not tied up yet.
Well, he wants that snake, bag and everything, out of here. I don't blame him one iota.
And now the snake goes to work. Still has that leather glove on, and certainly could be a factor in this encounter. He may have something in there. Jake not about to play by the rules anymore.
Tell me, if that glove had a little venom on it from the cobra, would that be a dangerous thing to have in the ring?
I would imagine if that glove got anywhere near his mouth or his eyes, sort of blinded. Oh, hard into the turnbuckle. Diamond already in serious trouble. He just started this encounter. Jake Snake Roberts sporting a new pair of boots. Several different skins from snakes comprise those boots, and there's a nice cobra eyes view.
Yes, it is indeed.
Oh, imagine in that bag, it is very dark. It looks as though lights will be out here for Diamond pretty soon.
No, I don't care how dark it is inside that bag, the snake can stay there. I have no sympathy for him. Look at Jake, a wicked, evil smile on his face there. He's really dealt some punishment out to Tony Diamond, and he's not flashing with brilliance like a diamond ought to.
Short arm clothesline. It's amazing that he can smile knowing that one Sid Justice has been in hot pursuit. Determined even the score on behalf of Mr. and Mrs. Macho.
Yes, absolutely. What an incredible, horrible, horrible thing that was at the wedding reception of Mr. and Mrs. Macho.
You saw the snake setting up for the DDT. The crowd here started to cheer, and he was not about to make them happy. He just dropped Diamond. He has really turned on the people that have supported him over the years.
Uh-huh.
And now locks in the DDT. Diamond is totally out of it.
A devastating blow. And Diamond, as you said so correctly, Sean, completely out.
Easy cover here for Jake the Snake Roberts. Now, your lordship, on so many past occasions, after an encounter is over, Jake the Snake Roberts would go over to the bag and bring out the python. Do you think he's going to once again uncover the cobra?
Well, I would hope not, because a python doesn't have venom, especially venom that is so powerful that a cobra has. So it would be tantamount to almost killing a Diamond if the cobra loose.
Not only is this a very dangerous thing here for Diamond, but what if that cobra got loose in the arena? We could lose one of the members of this crowd, and look at that snake. Ugh. We're going to take another look at some of the action here that Diamond suffered